Previously on The Walking Dead.
I know who you are.
I got another good one for you.
You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
And you keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly, you'll shift in with Doug.
You got it, boss.
Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
With or without you, I'm protecting my kid with my life.
And I don't give a shit about what happens to you. But if anything happens to my daughter or that little girl you've got with you, you watch your ass.
Damn it. What'd they get this time?
Looks like a rabbit.
Well, that's another meal lost. I still can't believe we went through all that commissary food in 3 months. It seemed like so much at the time.
Maybe you shouldn't have opened the door.
Yeah, except then I'd probably be food by now. Trust me, I have no regrets.
Rabbit's hardly a meal, Mark, but I'd take it. We're all hungry.
No kidding. Last night, I heard your friend Doug laying in bed just naming types of pie. It was driving me nuts. I think he's starting to lose it.
He's not the only one. Won't you cut him some slack?
Yeah, you're right. I wish I knew for sure how much food we have left. That much, huh? Does Kenny know?
I don't know.
You think Kenny's having any more luck than we are out here?
I sure hope so.
Yeah, between the lack of food and Kenny and Lily fighting all the time, things are getting pretty tense back at the motor inn. You know, Kenny's been talking about taking off if he can get that RV running. I think we're stronger as a group. I just don't know what'll happen if we start to break apart. Can't blame him, though. Did you hear Larry going off on him last night? What's the old guy's deal, anyway? Seems like he's got a problem with you in particular. And I know Lily thinks he's getting weaker, but the guy's all muscle. He's a walking pile driver. I know I wouldn't want to be stuck in a room with him. And didn't he punch you in the face one time?
Knock me flat.
Shit! Was that Kenny?
I don't know. Come on!
Ah!
Jesus Christ.
Oh, shit. No, no. Please don't kill us. We just want to help our teacher. We'll leave, I swear.
Lee, you guys okay?
Get it off. Get it off. God damn it. Get it off me.
Travis, maybe they can help.
These might be the same guys that raided our camp, and we barely got away from that.
What guys?
Why the fuck is there a bear trap out here?
I don't know, man. Lee, this is fucked up. We've gotta help. Please.
Ben, shut up. My dad was special forces. I know what I'm doing.
Just see if you can get him out. After that, you can leave us or whatever. I don't care. Please.
Hurry, please. Hurry.
Lee, this trap has been altered. There's no release latch.
Oh, no.
Shit. Walkers. It's now or never, Lee.
Please, get me out of this.
Mark, get the boys back. Kenny, keep those walkers off of me.
Why is this happening to us?
Lee, do something.
Please.
You have to get
out. Get me out.
You have to.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Try to cut the chain.
Hurry! There's so much blood.
Let's go! Let's go!
Oh, God! Please, save
Try
him!
Something.
Lee, it has to be now!
There's gotta be something we can do!
There's gotta be another way!
He's lost so much blood already!
Please,
hurry
Lee,
up!
Just cut off his fucking leg!
I want my leg.
You don't have time for that. I'm sorry, but we have to go! Now!
This can't be happening.
Jesus,
oh, man.
I need
oh, man.
To walk!
Lee, I can't keep him back forever!
Oh, Jesus, those things are gonna be here soon!
Please,
please,
please!
You can't just leave him like
God,
this!
There's so many of them!
Fuck,
come on, do something!
Now. We gotta go!
Come on, get it off!
Is he
gonna make it?
Why would somebody do this?
Please! Get me out
this
of this!
Bad. This is so bad.
Oh, God, he can't die!
Hurry!
There has to be a way out of this!
Come on!
Please hurry!
Christ.
Come on! We gotta go! Now!
No! No, don't leave me!
Damn it, Lee!
I'm sorry.
No! We can't leave Mr. Parker like that! Give me the gun! Give it
God
to me!
Damn it, let
Travis!
Go.
You gun!
Shit! What happened?
Oh, God.
Grab the kid and keep moving!
Come on, move!
You can't leave me like this. Please get me out.
Beth, the gate's open! We've got wounded!
Shit! What the hell are they doing?
Come on, come
on!
Oh
my god! What happened?
Oh,
what
the hell are these?
Don't have time to explain.
Please,
shit!
Are you okay? Get him into the truck. I'll see what I can do.
Cat,
okay?
Can you fix him?
Jesus, Ken!
Lee!
I don't know!
Lee! What the hell? You can't just be bringing new people here. What are you thinking?
Hey, you want to calm down for a fucking
hey,
minute?
No, I don't! I want to know why you thought bringing more mouths to feed was a good idea.
Jesus Christ. Come on, Lily. These are people. People trying to survive just like us. We've got to stick together to survive.
The only reason you're here is because you had food. Enough for all of us. But that food is almost gone. We've got maybe a week's worth left. And I don't suppose you guys are carrying any groceries, are you?
No.
Fine, you guys fight it out then. Welcome to the family, kid.
Come over here and see what I drew.
What? No, I...
Just come on, okay?
You know, you like to think you're the leader of this little group, but we can make our own goddamn decisions. This isn't your own personal dictatorship.
Hey, I didn't ask to lead this group. Everyone was happy to have me distributing the food when there was enough to go around, but now that it's running out, suddenly I'm a goddamn Nazi.
You've got nothing to say about that, Lee? You know, it might feel safe for you to sit on the fence, but sooner or later, you're gonna have to decide whose side you're on.
I don't see any of you stepping up to make the hard decisions. My girl's got more balls than all of you combined.
Dad, please. Why don't you go help Mark with the wall? You think this is easy for me? Everyone's starting to hate me because I'm the one that rations the food, but nobody else wants to. You know what? I'm not doing it tonight. You do it. There's today's food rations, but there's not enough for everyone. Good luck.
How you doing, Clementine?
Okay.
Where's your hat?
I don't know. Can you help me find it? Lee?
I promise. If I find it, I'll let you know.
Thank you.
Okay, Clem. I've got to take care of some things. Why don't you go back to playing with Duck for a while?
Okay.
Want something to eat? If your camp got raided, probably means you haven't eaten in a while.
I am really hungry. Thanks.
Are you out of your mind? We needed that food for us, for our kids.
Just because we don't know him doesn't mean he's not hungry.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to cause trouble.
You're fine, kid. Enjoy it.
Will you hold the damn board steady?
I'm trying. I didn't realize I was getting this weak already.
What do you want? A handout?
I got 60 cents in my pocket, if you'll shut up and quit being such a pansy.
Here, Larry. Lily would want you to keep your strength up.
That girl needs to quit worrying about me so much.
Oh, man. Just seeing the food is driving me crazy.
Need any help with the wall?
Nope.
Actually, we could use your axe. Do you mind if we take it?
Yeah, give us that thing for a bit.
Here, this should help. Try not to make too much noise.
Yeah, we're not stupid.
Come on, Larry. What is it between you two? Why do you have a personal grudge against Lee?
He knows why.
Hey, Doc.
What's up, Lee?
Don't suppose I could interest you in some food.
Actually, why don't you keep my share today? I know I said it didn't matter why you saved me and not Carly, but I owe you a lot more than half a day's rations.
Hey, if Doug doesn't want any food, I'll take it.
It doesn't work like that. I'll decide who gets the food.
Right. I'm sorry. The hunger's just getting to me. I'll let you do your job.
Is he gonna be okay?
I don't know. Can you give me a hand real quick? It's okay, I'll handle it. Just give me some space, okay?
Hey, Doug. What are you working on, Doug?
I've worked up a little warning system for outside. I know it doesn't look like much, but the bells will ring when walkers get nearby.
Think Katja can save that guy?
Maybe. I mean, I know about computers, but that doesn't mean I can fix a calculator.
But you probably could fix a calculator.
Well, yeah. Good point.
Take it easy, Doug.
You too, Lee.
Here, eat something.
Thanks, Lee.
I need to keep my strength up, too.
Not such an easy job, is it?
Hope I get to eat next time.
I don't envy you. I don't know how you have the strength to do this every day.
I don't have a choice.
What exactly is your problem?
Excuse me?
You had the food in your hands, and you didn't offer any of it to me or the kids. What kind of man are you?
Ken! Lee! Come here, please.
He didn't make it, did he?
He lost too much blood.
God damn it. I'm getting sick of this shit.
Ken, come back. There's nothing... I wish he wouldn't do that. That man you brought, I tried, but he was never going to survive.
Well, at least he's not our problem anymore.
What about the other kid?
The axe! Hurry!
it.
Fuck! I got him!
Bring him here in the first place, asshole!
Dad, calm down.
You're gonna get us all killed! Why didn't you tell us he was bitten?
What?
He was bitten, and you didn't say a goddamn word!
But he wasn't bitten, I swear!
Well, your not-bitten friend here came back to life and tried to kill my wife!
What?
Wait, you all don't know?
What the hell are you talking about?
It's not the bite that does it. You come back no matter how you die. If you don't destroy the brain, that's just what happens. It's gonna happen to all of us. When I first saw it happen, we were all hiding out in a gym, and everybody thought we were finally safe. But one of the girls, Jenny Pitcher, I think, I guess she couldn't take it. She took some pills. A lot of them. Someone went in the girls' room the next morning, and... God.
Doug, it works.
Of course it works. I told you.
Shit, where'd this string come from?
Watch where you're walking, man.
Who are those people?
I don't know. I'm telling the truth. I've never seen them before.
There's just two of them. We need to make a stand.
No, we have a routine. We don't confront them if we don't have to.
You all right?
Yeah, just getting untangled.
I don't know how you're still alive, man.
Sorry, Lily. We gotta do this. That's far enough!
Oh, shit! Okay. No problem. Looks like you folks got the motel locked down, which is fine, but if you could spare any gas, well, we'd be much obliged.
What do you need gas for?
Our place is protected by an electric fence. Generators provide the electricity.
Our generators run on gas. Look, we own a dairy farm a few miles up the road. If y'all be willing to lower your guns, we can talk about some kind of trade.
How y'all doing on food? We got plenty at the dairy.
Lee, why don't you and Mark check the place out? See if it's legit.
I'll go too. Improve the numbers in case we run into anything dead.
So, what are y'all thinking?
I think we'll stay here. We're starting to develop a good vibe here at the motel.
Good vibe? Well, Christ, Daddy-O. I'm sorry the folks with the food supply and defenses didn't tickle your pretty pink ass.
We need to think like a group, Lee. This affects everyone.
Then we vote. If everyone agrees, then we'll send you guys with some gas to check the place out.
And if we don't?
Then we'll stay in this wretched roach motel with your recreational paperweight over there. Plus, we stay close to Macon where we have access to the pharmacy. For Dad. Kenny? Katja?
We go.
Dad?
You betcha, Pumpkin.
Doug?
I say we do it.
I'm in. If they're offering food, we gotta at least check it out.
Clementine, what do you think?
Lee, I'm very hungry.
All right. Looks like we're going to a dairy.
So, this dairy, you guys really have food?
sure do. We lost most of the cattle, but we still have lots of milk, butter, and cheese stocked up.
And with the vegetables we grow, we got plenty of food.
Thanks for coming along, Doug.
Sure. I'd like to get a look at that electric fence they talked about. It might give me some ideas for something I can rig up at the motor end.
Can an electric fence really stop walkers?
Well, as long as the walkers aren't completely dehydrated and the fence has enough juice, yeah, it seems plausible. The electricity basically cooks you from the inside out, right?
I guess so.
So, if a walker stays in contact with the fence, it'll eventually cook its brain. Probably takes a while, though. And that can't be a good smell. Unless it smells like jerky. Man, I could go for some jerky. Ugh, I shouldn't have turned down that food you offered me earlier.
That is one runaway train of thought.
Sorry.
What's that you got there?
Oh, nothing. It's just a laser pointer I picked up during our last trip to the drugstore.
I mean, thank God Lee showed up when he did. Right, Lee?
Yeah, why don't you tell us a little more about yourself, Lee?
Where are you from?
Something tells me you're a local boy. You can always just kind of tell, you know? Y'all seem pretty settled in at that motor inn. Who's running things over there?
How many people you got over there anyway?
We've got a lot of hungry folks back there who really appreciate your food offer.
Well, here's to helping each other out. Well, we'd love to get you all out to the dairy. Like I said, we got plenty of food, and quite frankly, we could always use an extra helping hand.
In the summers, I used to help out on a goat farm.
Yeah, that's great. Everything helps.
Mama's been running the dairy for, well, as long as I can remember, but now it's getting...
You think you're gonna cut me out of this?
Shit, get down.
No one's trying to cut you out of anything.
You and Gary are always pulling this shit.
Bandits?
Who?
Those look like the people who raided my camp.
Who are they?
Fuck you! You knew we were hungry, and you guys were keeping it all for yourself!
What should we do?
Yeah, and you know what? We ate it all. What are you gonna fucking do about it?
Don't worry. Danny and I got you covered if something happens, but let's just wait this out. Hope they move on.
Fuck you!
Get to the dairy where it's safe. There it is. St. John Family Dairy. Y'all can see how we kept this place so safe.
The fence keeps them out?
You betcha. They fry like bugs in a zapper. We're pushing 4,000 volts through that thing with generators and amps.
Oh, wow. You guys must know a thing or two about running wire.
Had a guy who did, yeah.
And, we're gonna assume that your friend here... Lee is silently impressed.
Oh, wow. You've got enough electricity to run the whole place.
It's worth protecting. Hence all the juice.
I thought I saw y'all with company coming down the drive.
Guys, this is our mama.
I'm Brenda St. John, and welcome to the St. John Dairy.
This here's Lee. He, you never did say where you're from.
You were right. I'm a local boy.
They got a few more friends staying at the old motel.
Oh, my goodness, that place is pretty vulnerable. Have you got someone with survival experience to lead your group? Now that y'all are here, we'll make sure you're safe and comfortable.
We're starved.
These are for y'all. Baked fresh this morning.
Holy moly!
Can't get stuff like that anymore. Not without a cow for milk and butter, that's for sure.
That's right. Hopefully Maybelle will make it through this bout of whatever she's got and be with us for a good long while.
Your cow is sick? What's she...
We have a vet. We could bring her here. We can help you folks out.
A vet? Oh my! Our prayers have been answered.
Maybe our whole group could come for the day.
Well, how about this? Y'all go get your veterinary friend and I'll prepare some dinner. A big feast for all you hungry souls. It'll be nice to have some folks to help out around here again. Danny, why don't you come help me out in the kitchen?
Why don't I head back with the food and round up everyone for the trip back here?
Might want to take someone with you. Remember, those roads can be dangerous.
No problem. Ben can come with me.
Take this.
All right. See you later.
Mark, Lee, why don't you take a look around? Once you get settled in, I could use some help securing the perimeter.
Is there a problem?
Sometimes the dead get tangled up in the fence before they fry and end up knocking over a post. It'd be a big help if you could walk the perimeter. You can learn a little something about our fence. I'm gonna go top off the generators before they run dry. Come get me when you're ready.
You betcha. This place is incredible. It's got food. And that fence? Oh man, that fence. If we play our cards right, this might turn out to be a place we can stay. So how do you want to play this?
They're offering us food. We should do whatever we can to make these people like us.
The way Brenda was talking, I get the feeling like she'd be happy to have us stay.
All the more reason for us not to fuck this up. If Andy needs some help securing the perimeter, then that's what we do.
So what's your read on Andy so far? Think they'd be open to letting us stay?
Getting the perimeter secured is gonna help us a lot.
We'll be getting in good and making this place safer for us.
I'm gonna get back to it.
You guys decided to help us out. I noticed back at the motel that you folks are pretty well armed. Been stockpiling, huh?
We can't be the first people you've invited up to the dairy.
Well, no, we've made similar deals with other folks, trading for gas and food, but ultimately they moved on, looking for the people they lost contact with.
An electric fence is enough to keep out walkers?
Walkers? Is that what you call them? That's good. The old one wouldn't have, but Mac, he was our foreman, he figured out how to amp it up with the generators. We used to sit out here some nights and watch the sons of bitches sizzle and pop when they got too close. Closest thing to entertainment these days, I guess.
These generators are enough to power the whole dairy?
We got lots. We gotta keep trading for fuel as much as we can, but they all work together to do the trick. Like us.
Mark and I can help you with that perimeter now.
Oh, good. The fence will stop a walker in about 3 or 4 seconds, but gets overloaded if we leave the husks out there.
You know, Mark and I can clear the fence ourselves if you want to stay here and finish up with the generators.
Well, that'd be great. I'll turn off the northwest section, and if you guys could strip them off and look for any weak points, well, that'd be a big help.
Sounds easy enough.
Stay attentive. You never know.
Do you think we're doing enough to get the St. Johns to like us?
Well, we don't want to seem over-anxious. Showing them we can handle this fence is gonna go a long way.
I can't wait until everyone's out here. Everyone besides Larry.
He wouldn't be such a pain in the ass if you weren't telling him we were talking behind his back all the time.
I'm sorry, all right? Well, maybe a good meal will chill him out a little bit. There's one. Ugh. Lee, it's dead.
Come on, let's push it off. Looks like he's stuck. Disgusting. Come on. I'm sure there's still a few more.
Once this fence is patched up, this place will be a fortress. God, can you imagine not having to worry about the walkers anymore? So what's your take on the brothers? They seem to have this place tied down pretty well. Well, they seem decent enough. I just want you to know that I've got your back if anything goes down.
There's another one.
I see it. Never get used to the smell, do you?
Nope.
Christ. I can't stop thinking about dinner. Thanks for the rations earlier. It's not easy eating in front of the kids, but it's all that's keeping me on my feet right now. Well, let's just get this done. Maybe Brenda has some more bread in the house. Come on. I think I see where they're getting in. This one must have knocked it over trying to get through. He's tangled up in there pretty good. Come on, help me get this thing back in place so we can get Mr. Crispy off of here.
I think we'd get better leverage from the other side.
Good idea.
Little help here, Lee?
Holy fuck! What just happened?
The fences are on!
Why the hell would he turn the fence on? He knows we're out here. What the?
Get to the gate! Get down!
You asshole!
Jesus!
We had an agreement! Now you're fucked!
Who the fuck is that?
No idea!
Fuck! Now what?
With the fence on, that gate is our only way out! Can get through this fence and back to the house.
Ah!
They're on the
shit!
Boat. Did you really think you'd fucking live forever? Get closer! I see him! Where's our food, you asshole?
What happened?
Shit! It's one of the dead we pushed down earlier. Gonna have to move it.
Lee, get back here!
Did you really think you'd fucking us?
What about all the rain?
Where did they take you now, agreement? Now you're fucked!
Another one? How many of those things did we push down?
Didn't deliver the goods! Now we're gonna take one too.
Steve!
Behind the tractor!
You okay?
Yeah. Barely.
Come on. The gate's right there.
That will take a week. I already got one of you. You assholes.
Let's get out of here.
You lucky sons of bitches. Go ahead and run. We ain't going nowhere.
What's wrong?
Oh, my Lord! What happened to you, sweetheart?
It was those bastards in the woods, Mama.
Yeah, I'll be all right once it's out. God damn, it hurts.
Hey, y'all.
Mark, oh my God, what happened?
He got shot with an arrow.
Christ, are you gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I should just pull it out.
Oh, no, honey. Come on. Brenda's got you. Come on inside now. We'll have you all sorted out. Well, you must be the veterinarian.
What kind of shit is this?
We ran into some people on the way up here. Bandits, I guess. I think it was them that attacked us.
They gave us a lot of problems in the beginning. Killed a bunch of our farmhands. We were able to get them to stop by making a deal.
You knew about these people?
Food for protection. Not like we had much of a choice, but they did stop hassling us.
Christ, maybe you were right about this place, Lee.
Jesus, Lee. Say something.
Listen, we may have had an agreement with those people, but we will not stand for this shit.
Ain't no way we're gonna let those sons of bitches get away with this.
You know where these assholes are?
They're hard to pin down, but I think I know where at least one of their camps are. When you're ready to go scope out that bandit camp, come find us.
Bandits? Are you serious? This place isn't safe. We can't stay here.
Not safe? This place is a hell of a lot safer than that motor inn. I think all of us and our guns can handle a couple of punks with bows and arrows. What we need to do is find a way to get our whole group out here to stay. Take this place over if we have to.
Whoa, cool your jets there, Rambo. These are nice people. Let's not do anything to get us thrown out before we eat.
I'm gonna head out and help Dan deal with these bandits. You guys should try to make friends with Andy and Brenda while I'm gone.
Well, that's easy. I got charm coming out of my ass.
Yeah, that's real charming, Dad.
Where's Ben and Doug?
Since Doug ate half the biscuits on the way to get us, I had them stay back. I still don't think we should be trying to stay here, and someone's got to watch the motor in until we get back.
Hey, I remember seeing kids in your group, so I went ahead and fixed that swing while you were out. I hope your kids like swings.
A swing! I love swings! Just like at my treehouse! Come on, Doc!
Why don't you kids go and play on the swing, huh?
Yeah!
Thanks.
Anytime. We're looking out for you.
Lee, oh my God, I'm so glad you two didn't get killed out there. Do you think Mark will be okay?
Wish I knew, but I think he's in good hands now.
Yeah? It's not too bad?
He'll be fine. I've seen guys go through worse.
How could you all bring us to this place?
I take it you and Kenny didn't exactly make up on the way here.
I tried seeing things from his point of view, having a wife and kid and everything. But gambling with your family's life is pretty stupid, if you ask me. Hey, thanks for backing me up this morning at the motel. I know I came down on you guys pretty hard, but you do agree with the way I'm running things, right?
You don't have to say anything. You gave yourself away when you backed me up in front of Kenny, so thanks.
Hey. Hey, can I talk to you in private for a second?
Okay.
It's been 3 months. Your dad still treats me like I'm some kind of asshole.
Yeah, well, don't expect that to change. That's just how he is. Look, my dad can be an ass sometimes, I know that. But he's not a bad guy. He's got a lot of pain. He's been through so much, and lost pretty much everything. And it's hardened him, you know? Yeah, he's bitter and hateful, but that's all just to protect himself. And me. All he's got left in the world is me. And that goes both ways. So yeah, he's probably gonna keep treating you like crap, but that's just because he still has one thing left to care about. So don't judge him. Don't judge me for sticking by him. He's my dad, and I love him.
Think our little arrangement with them was a good idea?
A little late to be asking that now, don't you think?
Dad's right. Let's just wait for dinner. And then if Mark is feeling up to it, we leave. I don't want to push our luck here.
Now, let's not be hasty.
How do you feel about leaving the motor in?
It's a welcome change of scenery.
I don't know. If we'd just stayed where we were, then Mark wouldn't have ended up with an arrow in his shoulder.
I'm gonna go check things out.
Just don't get too nosy. These kinds of people are usually pretty protective of their privacy.
Yeah, and we don't need you poking your nose where it don't belong and getting us thrown out in our asses.
Hey, Clem, do you like the swing?
Yeah, it's fun.
Be sure to tell Andy thank you, okay?
I will. Will you push me on it?
Maybe later, okay?
Oh, okay.
What do you think of the dairy?
It's pretty. It reminds me of how things used to look before.
Yeah, it does.
Do you think things will ever get back to how they were? I miss the way things used to be.
Don't worry. We're safe here now.
As long as the bad people don't get me too, right?
I won't let what happened to Mark happen to you.
Promise?
I promise. How you holding up, Clementine?
I'm okay, I guess. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm just a little worried about Mark.
Is Mark going to be okay?
You got lucky out there. Could have been a lot worse.
Are you going to find the people who hurt Mark?
Man, we have to make sure they don't hurt anyone else.
Be careful. I want you to stay lucky, too.
Ever since I met you, I've had good luck, so don't worry.
Okay.
I've got some things to take care of. I'll be back in a bit.
Okay.
I've got some things to take care of. I'll be back in a bit.
Okay.
Fellas?
How you feeling, Lee? Look, I'm really sorry you almost got killed out there. We should have told you how dangerous it was.
No shit.
You saw what they did to your buddy. Nobody's safe here until we start to fight back.
But how?
The two of us should go out and do some recon. Then we'll all mount up for some revenge.
Hell yeah.
Who the fuck are these people in the woods?
We don't know. I think some of them used to work at the big box up the way.
Save lots.
Yeah. Anyway, they're nutty as all hell and get mad when they're hungry.
So are you ready to head out there and find their camp?
Yeah, we gotta work together on this. Those bandits are a danger to everybody. Let's do it.
I'll stay here and hold down the fort.
Remember, we're just doing reconnaissance for now. No use getting ourselves killed.
Are you going now?
Yeah, I'll be back soon, Clementine.
Please be lucky.
I will.
See anything?
Not yet.
I know it's around here. It's gotta be close.
Here.
Oh shit, you found it? You see anybody? Watch my back, Lee. I'm gonna check out the tent. This camp's too small. It can't be their main base.
That's what I was thinking.
Take a look around anyway. There's probably some shit around here they stole from us.
Nothing. Empty.
What's in the boxes?
They're all from save lots.
The first few days, they told folks to gather to the save lots by the interstate. Anything worth taking? I'll take that as a no.
Boxes from the dairy here.
Probably the food we've been giving them. Fuckers cross the line. What'd you find?
A video camera.
Let me see that.
Battery's dead, though.
Oh, good. What else they got over here? Let's see if we can find anything useful and then get a move on. I see you handled that gun I lent you pretty well. You a hunter?
No, but Lily keeps us all on a regular training schedule.
Lily, huh? Sounds like she's running this democracy of yours.
Just water. Empty, but it looks like someone's been eating out of these recently. Hmm. Looks like they were moving a lot of stuff.
Your guns down.
I ain't going back. You tell him Jolene ain't going back.
Hey, we had a deal. No shooting as long as we gave you food. What the fuck happened?
You had a deal with them. I ain't them. Oh, I know you. I know what you are. And I know what you do.
You don't know me.
Steal my shit. Steal everything from me.
We had a deal. You people broke it first.
Now, maybe you didn't hear me last time. When I asked you, sweet, put your damn guns down! You think I won't kill you? I'm gonna take this here crossbow and put a nice sharp arrow right through your eyeball. Into your goddamn brain. You're not men. You're monsters. All men are monsters. Take what they want and then destroy it all. Take a can of beans. Take a little girl. It's all the fucking same to you.
Forget it, Lee. She's batshit loco.
The crazy lady in the woods brings fresh meat to the farm.
You shut it now!
You know what? I changed my mind. I'm putting this arrow right through your balls. Yeah, right through. String them up on that tree. Then I'm gonna head down to that farm and shoot every goddamn person I see.
Okay, fuck this shit.
Go on, tell him, boy. Tell him what you got in mind for-
God damn it! It's a clean shot, though. Right through the forehead. That's good shooting right there. Still, what a waste.
So, that's it. We going back?
If they ain't here, I don't know where they are. And it ain't a good idea to go tromping through the woods looking for them. So yeah, we head back. Once they see this, they'll get the message. Come on. That was a hell of a ride, huh?
Jesus, Danny.
What? You ain't getting soft on them, are you? Not after what they did to your friend.
You're back. What happened?
Handled it, Mama.
This isn't what Terry would have wanted.
Terry?
My husband. Miss him every day.
Then screw it up for everybody then, why don't you?
Oh, calm down, Princess. I'll do it myself.
What's going on with them?
Dunno. Squabbling, looks like. A lot of tension with y'all, huh? Well, it's probably just the hunger talking. And Lee, don't worry your head about them bandits. I'm sorry you've seen more violence than I'd have thought in your short time. But you all are safe here. Don't worry.
Think I'll go have a look around.
Don't wander too far. Dinner will be ready before you know it. And thank your friend Koch again for me. She and the kids are in the barn with the cow. That woman is a lifesaver.
It's okay, Clementine. You can pet her.
It's okay. Go ahead.
Whoa. Katya says Mabel could have her baby tonight.
We'll see, Clementine.
What's this thing?
Daddy said it's called a salt lick.
Yeah, but don't lick it. It's gross.
Did you lick it?
I don't know.
Have I missed anything?
No, not really. It smells funny in here.
Like duty.
Kids?
How do you like that cow, Clint?
She's pretty.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
When do you think, we might eat?
Hungry, huh? Don't worry. Mama's cooking up some good grub.
How's the cow?
Well, better now we got Doc on the case.
We met this woman up in the woods. She seemed to know your brother.
He probably talks a little more than he oughta.
Thanks.
Yep.
You found it too, huh? Lee, they're hiding something behind this door. I got a quick look. They got boxes of stuff and something metal and sharp.
Don't get paranoid.
It's my job to be paranoid, Lee. I got my whole family on this farm right now. How about you? What about Clem? You gotta think about that little girl, Lee. Look, that guy with Katya. What's his name? He locked it up real tight the second we came in. I definitely heard a noise back there, Lee.
What?
My point is, we gotta know for sure. So go find a hammer or something, and I'll have this thing off in a second. You back me up in case them farmers come running.
Hang on, man. Think this through. You smash the lock. Then what if it turns out you're wrong? You just fucked your chance to get a good meal in those kids you're trying to protect. Use your head, Kenny.
All right, Professor. What'd you have in mind?
Let me have a look at what we're dealing with first.
Hey, Lee. You know how to pick a lock, right?
No. Why would you say that?
Well, you're, you know, urban.
Oh, you are not saying what I think you're saying.
Jesus, man, I'm from Florida. Crazy shit just comes out of my mouth sometimes. Sorry. What?
See those screws? Instead of breaking the padlock, we can just take off the assembly, have a peek inside, and then replace it all again like nothing ever happened.
All right. Sounds like you got a plan. I'll hang around and keep an eye on that guy with the cow.
Andy.
Shit, I thought that was Danny. Whatever.
Can I help you boys find something?
No, we're fine. Just looking around.
No problem. Hey, do me a favor. Don't fuck around with this door, okay? Just, you know, Mama gets nervous.
Andrew, I need your help again.
No problem. Right away, Doc.
So, how does a woman like yourself run this whole place?
Oh, I managed just fine. Plus, I had my boys to help out. I couldn't do it without them.
Damn, this thing is the worst piece of shit. Something's always tripping the breaker.
Careful, don't spook her.
Hey, Clementine.
My hat! You found it! Thanks, Lee.
Listen, did you give your hat to anyone?
No.
Did you see any strangers around the motor inn who might have taken it?
No. Why?
It's probably nothing. Just let me know if you ever see anything like that.
Okay, I will. Hey, Lee, do you think you'll ever have kids? Well, thanks for finding my hat.
You're welcome, Clem.
Do you want to pet the cow with me?
Nah, but you go on ahead.
Okay, honey, let's get that.
Dad! Dad! Come on! Let's eat!
Kenny, come along, honey. Kenny, come on. Don't make the children wait.
I'll make an excuse for you. Get that thing off.
Didn't you hear the bell? Dinner time. You know, you're a strange guy, Lee. Well, anyway, we best get going. I'll fix this door later.
Oh, Brenda, you are an angel.
Excuse a mess. We had to block the back door after Walker got upstairs. Don't worry. That was a while ago, and ain't been back inside since.
Everybody sit down. I'll go get the meal. Oh, this is a delight.
I could eat a horse.
Where's Mark?
Now, don't you worry about him. I've already brought some food up. You just let him rest.
Mind if I wash my hands first?
Bathroom's right outside in the hall. And be sure to get under your nails. You've been mucking around in the dirt all day. What's wrong? You look pale. Sit down. Your supper's getting cold.
Aw, sit your ass down, Lee. This lady has made you a meal.
Yeah, Lee. What's gotten into you?
He just had a start.
He could use some goddamn manners.
It didn't have to be this way.
Lee, sit down and eat your goddamn dinner. This woman made you a home-cooked meal, you ungrateful shit. Show some respect.
Thank you, Larry.
You don't even have the decency to take a handout when you're offered one. It just makes me sick. Really does.
That's enough, Larry.
Ken, maybe we should...
Hang on, Kat. Just keep Doug close.
Lee, what the hell is wrong with you?
Don't indulge him, Lily. There's always something with this guy.
Mom, I was eating that.
What is going on?
Everything could have turned out okay for you folks.
By the shock on your face, Lee, it looks as if you've been upstairs.
He would have died anyway. We gotta think about living.
Settle down, honey. Growing up in rural Georgia, you're taught not to waste. It's how I was raised and how I raised my boys. Now, you got monsters roaming around that do nothing but eat people. And for what? To continue to rot till they eat some more. We think we can put that meat to better use.
Oh, I'm gonna puke.
Andy is right. We go after folks who were gonna die anyways, one way or another.
like y'all.
All right, screw this. We're getting the hell out of here.
Nobody's going anywhere.
We got lots of use for y'all right here.
What the fuck? The fucking black
Put your
fuck?
Guns down! We're walking
Don't
out of here!
Don't go near my fucking family!
I don't want to die. Mommy, what did I eat?
Stopped us in time!
Come on, Dad. Now's not the time.
They locked us in here. I think it's a meat locker.
Those psychos have caught you in Duck!
Open up!
If they so much as touch my family, I'll kill those sons of bitches!
Dad! Please stop!
I'm scared.
Don't be. It's gonna be okay. I'm gonna find us a way out of here.
You're worse than the walkers!
Dad, please! Settle down!
I'll rip your gun!
Your dad's not making things any easier for us.
Open the fucking
Dad,
door!
Dad, stop!
God damn it! Come on, show yourself, fucking cowards!
Dad!
There's more of us on the way! Let us out now, if you want to
They got caught you in Duck,
Lee!
Those fuckers have my family!
I know! We're gonna get out of here and find them.
They're not gonna open the door!
You think a fucking apocalypse gives you the right to chop people into meat? I'll break that damn door down!
Dad, you can't get... Easy!
Oh, God.
Dad? No. Dad, come on! Dad! Oh, God. He stopped breathing. I think he's had a heart attack.
Shit. Is he dead?
He's not dead! Somebody help me!
Fuck. If he's dead...
He's not dead!
What has to happen, Lee? Think about it. You saw that poor bastard at the motel? How fast he turned?
What are you saying?
Lily, I'm sorry. I truly, truly am. But in a few minutes, we're gonna be stuck in a locked room with a 6'4", 300-pound, seriously pissed off dead guy.
Fuck you! We can bring him back! Lee!
Right now, we have to keep him from coming back.
No! God damn it, Kenny! He's not dead!
Look, we're running out of time. If you don't want to deal with this, I will.
Kenny, listen!
Don't think I forgot about what you said at the drugstore. When you all thought Duck was bitten, well, I'm just doing the same thing. Except Duck wasn't bitten. And we know this guy's not gonna make it. Remember what Ben said. Gotta destroy the brain. Come on, Lee. You can't be in the middle on this one. You gotta have my back this time.
God damn it, Lee. I need you. Please help me. Come on, Dad. Come on. Wake up. Wake up. Come on. This has happened.
You're useless, Lee!
You asshole!
I'm sorry. I'm
It had to be done.
Look, I'm sorry. Are you okay?
Is it over? I didn't want Larry to die.
I know, baby. I know.
I know. But you gotta be strong right now. I need you to be strong. Think about something else, something hopeful.
Like what? We're gonna get out, right? You found a way out?
I'm working on it.
He was still alive, Lee. He was still alive. I know. There's nothing to be said. He'll learn. Wait till it happens to him.
There ought to be an air duct behind this unit. Maybe big enough for one of us to fit through.
Does the air conditioner come off?
I think I could take it off if I had something to remove the screws. The multi-tool. Of course they took it. Shit.
Maybe there's something else we could use. I've got a rock.
A rock won't help, but a coin might do the trick. Do you have a coin?
Uh-uh.
It's not coming off that way.
I need to be alone.
God knows you deserve time to grieve, Lily. But if we're gonna get out of here, we need your help. And Larry's. I think I may have found a way out of here, but I need something to remove the screws on the air conditioner. If you had something I could use as a screwdriver, a coin or something.
No.
What about him? Look, I know this is a terrible time for it, but back at the motor inn, Larry mentioned something about keeping coins in his pockets.
What do you want? My blessing to loot his corpse?
Your permission.
Do what you have to do.
Oh, boy. Any idea which pocket he keeps his change in?
My mother's.
Don't worry. I'm not taking it. Here we go. 2 quarters. And a dime. Just gotta remove these screws and get this unit off. Not coming off that way.
Hurry the fuck up, Lee. We don't have all day here. Well, there's our way out, Lee. Small vent, but maybe Clementine can fit through. Looks like it'll probably lead right into that back room.
It's okay. I'll go. I just want to go home.
I'll be right here if you change your mind and decide to come back.
Okay.
You're gonna be fine.
get out.
See if you can get to the other side of that door and open it.
Slaughterhouse.
Grab his gun?
Good a plan as any.
Outside the bar.
Oh, shit. Just guarding the place, like you said.
Keep sitting out in the rain like a damn deer. Mama says we can't keep that many folks alive and not expect trouble. Take one to keep and kill the rest.
Can I pick which one to keep alive?
Not the kid. Not enough meat on the tray.
Oh, I know, Mabel. This
take
is my favorite
through the cracks.
Too. When I let worm think they can just walk right out, they never even look down.
Hey, tell me something.
Sick fucker thinks this is a game.
Damn it, Lee, this is not the time to freeze up. Keep it simple. As soon as he passes us, jump in from behind. See what he's doing now.
Now, don't you? You can have me. It's how the world works now.
Get part of yourself so others can live.
I should fucking kill you right now.
You gotta keep me alive. If you kill me, the meat gets tainted. You can't eat it.
You're already tainted.
You ain't gonna kill me.
This is not how the world works now. You won't make me kill you!
Go. I'll cover you.
Just stay here and keep Clementine safe. I'll be right back. Where's that coming from? Doug? Ah! Doug? Doug, what the hell was that?
Morse code.
You almost blinded me.
Sorry about that, but I did get your attention. We heard screams from the bar. What's going on? Lee, you okay?
Larry's dead. They chopped off Mark's legs and tried to feed him to us.
Jesus, that's sick.
They've still got Duck and Katja in the house. And I don't know where the fuck Kenny is.
All right, we're coming in to help.
No. If we storm the house, we'll cause a panic. You two try to find a way around to the back. I'll head to the front.
You got it. Come on, this way.
Wait, are you sure?
Yes. No. Yes.
No, no, please, no, no, no! Keep shut up and you'll be fine.
Oh, I'm gonna take the boy and check around.
No, please don't take my boy!
Let go, woman.
Settle down.
Andy? Danny, is that you? What's going on out there?
You know you don't want to do this.
Just go away and leave us be. Stop right there, I mean it.
Think about what you're doing. It doesn't have to end like this.
I'll kill her, Lee.
Just let me go.
Stay back! Don't do innocent stuff!
Go, Brenda.
Please, listen to him.
I'll do it.
Please.
I don't want to kill you, Lee.
Please don't make this any worse.
Just stop.
You ain't shit!
It's over!
Fuck you! As soon as Danny and Mama get out here, you're all fucked!
Don't you dare walk away from me, Lee! Get back here and finish this, Lee!
Oh!
Hey, Lee. I'm sorry for leaving the motor in unattended.
I never thought a laser pointer would be the thing that saved our lives.
Anyway, I'm glad you're safe. Were they really chopping up people? For food?
Yeah, and Clementine ate some. Oh, it's my fault. I panicked and didn't stop her.
Ugh. Were you guys able to salvage anything good from the dairy?
Not really. St. John's took everything I had before the place got completely overrun with walkers.
Oh, I was able to grab a couple of your things back while Brenda wasn't looking.
It doesn't work. You have any use for it, Doug?
It's just a basic camcorder. A save lot's cheapy. Let me check it out, see if I can get it working.
How are you doing?
I'll be fine. Just not as young as I used to be. Hon, go on ahead and give me and Lee a second. There's gonna be fallout.
For killing Lily's dad? Yeah, I would imagine so.
What do you think? Fine, then. Fine. I saved Duck on the farm and didn't save Sean. Now I kill someone before I can put your little girl in danger, and I'm even more of a monster. I don't care. You do what you have to do. I'm gonna keep doing what needs to be done.
Come on, Clementine. Stay close.
Lee, did you have to kill those men? I'm glad we're still alive.
Hey, Dad, what's that noise?
Sounds like a car.
Oh, God, not more strangers.
Don't shoot! We're here to help!
Figures.
Oh, crap! Baby, you gotta see this. It's a shitload of food and supplies back here.
This food could save all of us.
Not all of us.
Look, we don't know if these people are dead.
If they come back, then we're just monsters who came out of the woods and ruined their lives.
This stuff isn't ours.
Dad, whose car is it?
Don't worry about that, Duck. It's ours now.
It's abandoned, Ducky. Don't worry.
What if it's not? Well, what if it's not abandoned? What if it is someone's?
We have to take this, Clementine. We need it to survive.
I'm sorry, sweetheart, but it's not about right and wrong anymore. It's about survival.
It's locked.
No shit, I already tried that. But I heard you take the keys from up front.
Supplies?
I'll take it.
More food in here. Great. Maybe we'll survive this after all. Duck, why don't you carry this?
Okay.
Got a box of food here.
I'll carry it.
This hoodie looks to be about your size. Why don't you hold on to this? It might get cold.
It's not mine.
We're not like the bandits, honey. We didn't hurt anybody to get this. Understand?
I guess so.
Here, Clem. Want some batteries? Hey, Lee. You know that camcorder? I got it working. You might want to see this.
Look at you. Oh, you need a mama, sweetheart. We won't let them bandits get you, will we? No.
Okay.
Where's your hat?
I don't know. Can you help me find it?
Sorry, hon. I don't have time.
That was my favorite hat.
I promise. If
I'm thinking you're safe, sitting there acting like things are the way they used to be. The dead don't kill their own. It's the living you've got to be afraid of. The people I used to call friends. People who just... Don't worry, little girl. Bandits got their eye on that dairy. As long as they keep getting food from them, you'll be safe. I promise.
This place is done. It's time to move on.
Screw it. Not like you ever listen to a damned word I say.
Is this all you got?
I told you this town is tapped. Do you have any idea what we had to do to get all that? We need to leave.
Duck was asking about the farm last night. Not much phases. It's starting to add up. I need to get to the coast. Get him out of all this madness. Lily's not doing so good, huh?
You murdered her dad.
I did what I had to, and you know it. Maybe people out there got things lined up better. Better than us, at least. Could be folks who have all this shit figured out.
Do people get mad when they're scared?
Sometimes, yeah, they do.
You're so full of bullshit!
I'm the one keeping this group going!
We can sort all this out, alright? We can sort this out!
I'll tell you what we need to sort out. We can't let one person fuck this up for everyone else!
Alright, I want to thank you guys for watching episode 2 of season 1 for The Walking Dead Ugly Choices. Please let me know what you think of the ugly choices and where we go from there. We're going to hop right into episode 3 and in my next video, and I will see you guys in that one. Thank you.